Namaskar students. Students, today in this video, I'm going to start exercise 13.2 of chapter 13, Exponents and Powers. In this video, I'm going to solve question number 1. So, let us begin. We have learned different laws of exponents in our previous video. We are going to apply all these law of exponents. Simplify this and write the answer in exponential form. So let us begin. See over here. Here the question is given 3 to the power 2 into 3 to the power 4 into 3 to the power 8. I can see here the base are same. Okay. 3 is a base but the power are different. So which law I am going to apply? See, I have written over here a to the power m into a to the power n. When the base is same and the power are different and multiplication sign is there, you need to add the power. See, a to the power m plus n. Base is same and I just added the power. So same thing we are going to apply over here. If the base are same, power are different, you just need to add them. So what I am going to write? Write the base as it is and add all the power. Because base are same, so I have written 3 and add all the power. That is 2 plus 4 plus 8. So now add it. 8 plus 2, 10. 10 plus 4, 14. So 3 to the power 14. So this is your answer. So this way you have to apply the law and you have to write the answer. Now see number 2. See, 6 to the power 15 divide 6 to the power 10. I can see the base are same, power is different. Recall the law of exponent that we have learned. See, I have written over here a to the power m divide a to the power n. That means when the base is same, power are different and division sign is there, you need to subtract the power. That is m minus n. So now let us do it. As base is same, keep it as it is. Keep the base as it is, 6. And now what we are going to do? As a division sign is there, so we are going to subtract the power. 15 minus 10. So now write 6 as the base and now subtract the power. 15 minus 10 gives what? 5. So this is your answer. So this way, student, you have to see, you have to learn all this law of exponent, apply it, simplify it and write the answer in exponential form. Now see over here, it is given 7 to the power x into 7 to the power 2. So how you are going to solve? I can see the base is same but the power is different. Now here you can see, here it is given x. So no need to worry if number is not given, if any alphabet is given, 7 to the power x is given, no problem. What you are going to do? You are going to apply this law. See, base is same, power is different. So what I am going to do? Add the power. So let us do it. 7 to the power x plus 2. This is your answer. Which law I have applied? A to the power m into a to the power n is equal to a to the power m plus n. You have to also write the law. Which law of exponent you are applying, that you need to write. Like see, I have written over here in front of it, same way I have written over here and same way I have also written over here. If you don't write the law, the marks will be not given. So please clarify it that when I am solving this, I need to write the law. Now next one. See number 5. After number 2, I have shown you the number 4. You are going to do the number 3 by yourself. Now number 5. See, 5 square, it is given in a, it is written in a bracket, and outside the bracket again 3 is written in the power, right? Then divide 5 cube. So how you are going to solve? First of all, I need to solve this. Recall the law of exponent that we have learned. This law we have learned, right? What it is? A to the power m in a bracket, outside the bracket again n is written in a exponent, is written in the power. Okay, so how we are going to solve this? That is, A is written as it is, multiply the both the power m into n. A to the power m in a bracket, then n, that is equal to A to the power m into n. Apply this law over here. First of all, solve this using this law. So, let us solve it. What it gives? 5, 2 into 3. I am applying this law. Understand, I am applying this law over here. Okay, so that gives what? 5 to the power 6. I got it, 5 to the power 6. After multiplying 2 into 3, that is 5 to the power 6. I got it. Now put this over here. Put it over here. That is 5 to the power 6 divide 5 to the power 3. Okay. So now what? Which law you are going to apply? See, base is same, power is different. Again, see this one. Can you recall this law? Just now we have learned it. So you are going to apply. So let us apply it and write it down. So keep the base as it is, and what you are going to do with the power? Subtract the power. That is 6 minus 3. That is equal to 5 to the power 6 minus 3 gives a 3. 5 to the power 3, that is your answer. So this way we have applied a two law. The first law is this one. That is applied for this one, this portion. After getting the answer, I have kept it over here in an exponential form. And then again, I have applied the second law, that is this one. Okay. And after that, we have solved it. And we what we got? 5q. So this way, you have to see. You have to, first of all, learn all the law of exponent. And now apply it, simplify it, and write it. Write the answer in exponential form. Now see number 6. Here I can see base is not same, but the power is same. Recall the law that we have learned. The law tells us that if the base is not same, power is same, what we are going to do? Take the base in a bracket, that is A into B, and take the common power outside the bracket. A into B to the power m. A to the power m into b to the power m, that is equal to a into b in a bracket to the power m. So this law we are going to apply over here. See, power is same but base is not same. So what we are going to do? We are going to multiply 2 into 5. We have taken 2 into 5 in a bracket and take the power common outside the bracket, that is to the power 5. 5 is written common. 2 into 5 in a bracket to the power 5. Now multiply 2 into 5, that gives what? 10. 10 to the power 5. So this is your answer. So I think, student, now it is clear to you. Now let us do the next one. See this one. You are going to do the number 7 and 8 by yourself. And now I am showing you the 9. Over here, see, according to the simplification, we have to solve the bracket first, right? So let us solve the bracket first. Here I can see what it is written in the bracket. I can see 2 to the power 20 divide 2 to the power 15. Which law you are going to apply? We are going to apply this law. See, that is 8 to the power m divide a to the power m, that is equal to a to the power m minus n. So we are going to apply this law over here, that is given in a bracket. So let us do it. That is, first of all, let us solve this one. Let us solve this one. That gives what? 2 to the power 20 minus 15, that is equal to 2 to the power 5. We got this one. We got the answer in exponential form. Now we are going to put 2 to the power 5 over here. After solving this portion, what we got? 2 to the power 5. And now let us put it over here and multiply with 2 to the power 3. Now which law we are going to apply? Recall, We are going to apply this law. That is a to the power m into a to the power n equal to a to the power m plus n. So base is same, power is different, and multiplication sign is there. So we are going to solve like this. 2 to the power 5 plus 3, that is 2 to the power 8. So this is your answer. So student, I think it is now clear to you. Go through this, solve the question number 1 of exercise 13.2 and complete it. So this is the end of the video. In the next video, I am going to show you how to solve question number 2 of the exercise 13.2. Thank you. Namaskar.